And I'm watching your video and maybe it's see my shoulders moving. I'm doing some crocheting right now too. So we're about to review this and give you some amazing feedback.
Great. So just so you know, we did have a little bit of room change. Do you guys hear me this way? Okay, good. So we did have a room change and I want to make sure you guys are in the right class. This is the class from scarcity to abundance. Correct? You guys are here. I want to make sure you're learning what you want to learn, obviously.
Okay, good acknowledgement. Remember to keep your hands off your face, generally speaking. You look really cute, by the way.
Raise your hand.
Good, Kirsten. Very good.
And then if there was a money tree, and if money trees were a real thing, who would want that? I totally would.
I would say who would want one?
And if I could teach you
or two or five.
On how to create what you want. And the minute you need it, anytime you need it, who wants to learn them?
Okay, creating what you want and the minute you need it is a very, it's a very big promise. Creating what you want and the minute you need it is a very big promise. I'm okay with it as long as you can fulfill on this. So I'm going to be watching for that during your presentation.
I live in abundance. But it wasn't always that way.
Okay, watch your pinchy hand.
You see, there was a point in my life where I was at scarcity. This was a very hard situation in my life. My whole life, I wanted to be a mom. All I wanted was to have my own child, my own beautiful baby. I got married later in life, and I finally had my son.
So, just a second, I'm recording.
And I thought life would be so perfect once now that I had my child. But I didn't hard pregnancy was
going
to be on my body.
Okay, use your stage. I want you to move around the stage.
I was going to be. And the misery that was going to step into my life. You see, after pregnancy, my body started shutting down. I thought, okay, I had my baby. All this weight's going to magically come off. No, that didn't happen. In fact, more weight came on. And I thought, okay, I have my baby, I'm going to have all this time to spend with him. No. I didn't have that time. Instead of being with my child, I was in bed. The only quality time I had with my child was when he was next to me, playing on the tablet. And doctors couldn't give me an answer as to what was wrong with me. And I was so sick, I had to quit my job.
As an audience member, I'm
our second income.
Wondering how your body's relating to
and
abundance.
I was so sick that my bills were piling up. And it was Christmas time. And we didn't know how we were going to eat.
Okay, now you're getting into it.
I didn't know how I was going to pay for my medical tests. And I had no idea on how I was going to. I was living in scarcity. I was in scarcity with my health.
Good, there's your tie-in.
And I was in scarcity with my relationships.
I like your steps. I want
to
see more
and I got
emotion.
This will not be my life. I will not be in scarcity. I'm here to tell you that we don't have to live in scarcity. We don't have to have scarcity in our health. We don't have to have scarcity in our bodies.
Good, amping
we
up.
We don't have to have scarcity in our personal power.
You're creating a state
and
change. Good.
We do not have to have scarcity in our finances ever again. My promise to you today is to teach you the two tools.
Lots of this body motion.
Out of scarcity and into abundance. Who is with me? Raise your hand. Woo! All right, we deserve abundance. We deserve it, because this is our birthright, my friends.
All right, so your emotional barometer, if you this watch my mouse on the screen here, this was your neutral zone. Your emotional barometer started out here, and then it went to a low point, but it could have gone down here for a low point, and I feel like we only went here for a low point. So when we came back out of it, we came really high energy here, but we could have gone a little bit higher too. So make your waves a little bit higher and a little bit lower. You got an automatic verbal response on your promise. That's awesome.
Now let's get on the same page. I always like to do definitions, so we're all talking the same lingo. When I say scarcity, how would you define it?
Okay, get out into the audience. Walk out into the audience.
Lack, lack. Thank you, Jennifer. Who else has an answer? Not having enough. Not having enough. Who else has an answer?
Very safe frame up of your question.
I like how you say limited. So I love the dictionary. The dictionary is like one of my friends because it helps me get grounded and I know what I'm talking about. So when I look up scarcity, it means in short supply. It's limited.
Okay, the dictionary helps me get grounded? I'm kind of wondering about that.
There's not enough. We have a lack. So let's get a really great visual in our head of what scarcity is. And it's like an onomatopoeia or a play on words. Scarcity, scared city. Okay. When I think of scared city, I think Black Friday at Walmart.
Good response.
I know what I'm talking about, right?
Okay, I've been waiting to see the response in a big audience on that one. I love it.
You just had your Thanksgiving dinner. You sat with your friends. And it's like 5 o'clock. You're going through the mailers. And you're looking at the Walmart mailer, right? And you're like, oh my gosh, blenders. They're on sale. And they're $10. But there's only $100 blenders. There's only 100 of them. I have to hurry and go to Walmart. So I am like running to Walmart, get out of my way, pushing and shoving everyone to get to these $10 blenders. People are literally killing each other to get to these blenders because there will never be any $10 blenders ever again. And they're all here.
Okay, you have got the audience in the palm of your hand, which is fantastic. That's awesome. When you have that, use those pause moments that you've got. Use silence here too to let the laughter roll. This is a great opportunity for added silence.
Oh, mine, right here.
Okay, keep talking. I just said silence. When you're walking on the stage from this distance to this distance, make it filled with either a silence that's intentional or keep us with you, keep us talking.
It's true. And we do this all the time. Scarcity, scared city. So let's do the opposite. What's abundance? Let's get some definitions on what abundance is.
There's plenty and more.
All right, we're gonna sing song.
There's plenty and more.
There's plenty and more. What's your name?
Barbara.
Thank you, Barbara. Who else has a definition? Yes. Yeah, great answers. Brittany?
Overflowing.
Yes.
There's always enough.
There's always enough. Guys, this is abundance. There's plenty and more. It's overflowing. There's always enough. So often in life, we're so stuck and scared to say.
So when you're speaking, I'm going to invite you particularly to omit as often as possible the phrase in life. We can just say so often and rather than having to say so often in life because it makes it more applicable to them if you just drop that phrase.
And it's our God-given fight or flight mechanisms that are going on. And these fight or flight mechanisms are tied to our survival. So imagine if you were on a deserted island. You've got to survive. You're all by yourself. I mean, you're not going to lay down and die. So if you're on a deserted island, you need to survive. What tools do you need to create? What tools do you wish you
A lot of the women that you'll be speaking in front of are at the point where they would just lay down and die. So when we're saying, you're not just going to lay down and die, I would just omit that part and say, you're on a deserted island and your highest priority is survival. I would just give that gift of intentional survival to them.
You had, so you could create abundance on the island. Raise your hand if you have an idea. Beautiful Barbara again.
I'm just thinking it was the first thing that came to my mind was a fishing pole.
I love it.
You're so good with the crowd.
We got a fishing pole. Yes. All right. Hostess. Oh, yes.
My thoughts, Hostess. I mean, so it's in my mind.
Cool. So your number one tool will be your thoughts.
Yeah.
Good acknowledgement. Try not to bend over quite so far to her.
Good. Love it. Who else has an idea? What else did you return to their diet? Return again.
So this might be kind of the same thing as her, but knowledge. Like when I watch The Martian, and I'm like, if I was stranded on Mars, what would I know enough of to survive like Matt Damon? So knowledge.
Cool. So we have people who want to be prepared.
How can I survive like Matt?
And we have beautiful Barbara, who's incredible.
These ladies are having so much fun, Kirsten. Good job.
So we have beautiful Barbara who wants a fishing pole. Cool. So if I was on a deserted island, there are two tools that I would bring. And you guys have two tools as well. Because these tools are going to be a part of your mindset, like Brittany and this beautiful lady said, as well. The first tool I would bring with me on the deserted island would be a bucket.
We've got this motion going on a lot.
What do we use buckets for? Carrying things, catching water. That's right. We need to drink things, right? Humans, you can only go so long without water. So, and did you know a child's first expression of love is through food? It's through drinking. So often we withhold love, we withhold abundance from ourselves. We feel we're unworthy. And that's not okay. To create the abundance we want, we need to have a bucket of abundance.
Okay, I like this concept of the child's first expression of love. It has a couple snags in it. The first one is, I don't know why you said it at this point. A child's first expression of love is drinking. I get that it's related to your bucket. It just is disconnected as far as, are we talking about expressions of love or are we talking about abundance? Secondly, when we say expression of love is drinking, that can be a sticky phrase because it can sound like alcoholism. I know you're not referring to that as children, but you have people in your audience that may interpret it as that.
This bucket will hold all the abundance we want. A broken bucket can never be full. Think about that.
Say it again.
A broken bucket can never be full.
Thank you.
If you want the riches of the universe, if you want a healthy body, if you want a rockin' marriage, if you want all the personal power in the world, you need to be a strong and powerful bucket to hold it all. We are our buckets of abundance. Sometimes our buckets get cracked. They get deemed in debt. Welcome to life, right? These buckets get cracked from limiting beliefs we create about ourselves, negative experiences. If someone broke up with me and I was in a relationship, I might think, gee, I'm unlovable. There's a crack.
Oh, hang on.
Child's first expression of love. If you want all the personal power in the world, if I failed a test, or I got fired from a job, wow, I guess I'm not good enough. Or what
Okay, connect that with, you're giving us wonderful examples. Amazing, amazing, wonderful examples. You told us before that those are limiting beliefs. And as an audience member that's never heard this before, I might not know what a limiting belief is. So if you're doing it here, when you're giving that limiting belief, just tell us that's a limiting belief. That's a crack in our bucket.
If I failed a test, or I got fired from a job, wow, I guess I'm not good enough.
Limiting belief, crack in the bucket.
Or what if I hit enough trouble calling while I'm driving? Gee, I guess I'm stupid. Is my bucket strong?
Okay, very good. You're making it very, very clear here.
What are some other cracks and limiting beliefs that you've seen people have?
Good. You connected cracks with limiting beliefs. That was good. I want you to try spreading out your fingers when you're talking.
The amazing Barbara. She has all the answers. I just hear that. I've got the crack in the bucket. That's how I know this. Okay, cool. Being stuck.
And so when you think of being stuck,
what's the belief behind that? Remember to keep yourself standing. Give me 2 seconds. I'll come back to you. You'll be my first volunteer. Awesome. Okay. What other limiting beliefs? Oh, this wonderful lady back here, and my cord so does not reach.
No, that's fine. Saying, oh, I can never do anything right. I can never do anything right. Why even try? I go hide in my corner. Let's go.
Yes. I just returned from girls' camp.
Yeah.
And it was really sad for me to hear these beautiful young girls who have bodies that we all wish we had and hair that we all wish we had because we're all getting old.
Yeah.
And they are beautiful, and they all think they are fat and ugly, and it's, they're growing up this way is heartbreaking. So I think we all grew up that way too.
We did.
So that's, I think that's extremely limiting to all of us.
No, that's true. It's true. We all think we're ugly. We all think we're worthless. We all think we're dumb.
Okay, a stronger way to acknowledge that would be, sometimes we think we're worthless. Sometimes we think we're ugly. Instead of we all think we're worthy, we all think. I would say that as a sometimes, not a always. Just keep away from the blanket statement.
I when we find these beliefs in ourselves, kind of beat yourself up for it, don't you? Oh man, silly me. Why would I do that?
I'm wondering why you're not wearing shoes.
I know, right? Let's quit kicking the bucket. Guys, we don't need to kick the bucket.
Is that your music?
We don't need to be mad at ourselves.
Where's that coming from?
For these negative thoughts and limiting beliefs we've had. And I'm going to tell you the story of the art kintsugi. My husband's a musician in Japan, so it's kintsugi. Has anyone heard of kintsugi? No? You're gonna love this. 15th century Japan. There was a warlord. He conquered many territories, and he was over all these territories. He's a big guy. And he had this beautiful bowl that he loved. He got it from the Chinese. It's far away. Prized possession. Ate all of his favorite foods in it. And then one day the bowl fell and it broke.
Watch out for T-Rex arms.
His favorite bowl was broken.
You're doing such an amazing job, Kirsten. I'm loving this.
Showman's like, I'm a showman. My favorite things do not get broken. I need this fixed. So he sent the bowl back to China. Chinese, please fix the bowl. Please help it. The Chinese look at the bowl. And they come up with a solution. They put metal staples in the bowl. So the bowl is back together. It's functional. But it's not beautiful. And he looked at his bowl. Said, this is a good one. So he turned to his artisans. And he gave the artisans the bowl. He said, please. Please. Make that bowl in the U.S. Make it beautiful. So the artisans looked at the bowl. And they decided to fill the cracks with gold. Metal stamens were covered. The Chauvin received it back. King Tsugi means to fill with gold. And it comes from the ancient belief of wabi-sabi, which means that the cracks in the bowl are just a story in the history of the bowl. The bowl is beautiful for having experienced imperfection. My friends,
good statement.
We are beautiful.
Good follow-up.
For having experienced imperfection. It is that imperfection that makes us unique, that makes us irreplaceable. It cannot be replaced. Your value cannot be measured.
Okay, time to state change.
I'm looking for a volunteer. Someone who thinks...
Remember to say in a moment.
...they need help filling their cracks with gold. Someone who feels that maybe they have a dent in their bucket that they need help repairing. If you feel this is...
Instead of saying need help repairing, say that they would like to repair.
Come up, please.
So before this point, it would be wonderful to have them close their eyes and ground. Think of their own cracks. Think of their own dents. Think of the limiting belief that's come up for them specifically before you ask for a volunteer. And then when you have them think of their limiting beliefs, you say, and now I'm looking for someone who's willing to join me on stage. And in a moment, I'm going to have you raise your hand once you've got that belief. And if you're the person that wants to come up and you would like to have these cracks filled with gold, and you would like to see these mistakes be made beautiful. If that's you, raise your hand. So say something so that they can ground and raise their hands with their eyes closed.
Thank you so much for volunteering. What's your name?
Shandy.
Shandy. That's a beautiful name. Thank
Okay, Kirsten, I'm going to have you quarter out to the audience, which means turn your shoulder, this shoulder right here, turn it out to the audience a little more.
6 years since I lost my mind. You've been struggling with it for 6 years since you lost your last baby.
Okay.
And when you think about this belief, what's the first memory that comes up? When you think of this fear, what is the belief that you have about yourself?
Okay, so in this moment, she is getting so raw and vulnerable, which is so impressive. With burying, oh my gosh, that's a heavy... heavy thing that I think it would be wise at this point to acknowledge her, not with a round of applause, but say something along the lines of, that sure can be way painful, or acknowledge the pain that she's going through. You're not buying her story in doing so, but you're acknowledging that she's brave enough to open up this idea and look at it and share it in front of so many people. So just hold her space in that beautiful healer way.
I'm a healer.
something that I did caused his death.
How has this been?
Okay, we're going to be training on how to do belief breakthrough on stage so that there's interaction with the audience. You've got a great moment with her on stage here, but your audience is not being acknowledged.
This belief is hurting you. It hasn't because it's kept you in rut. Sometimes we choose to stay stuck and in ruts because we feel it keeps us safe.
I don't know if I can say part.
Okay, so that's a good bit of feedback for you. She said she doesn't feel safe. Think about where she's at right now. Think about, observe her body language. She's protecting herself here. So if she doesn't say anything about safety, don't repeat that back to her. Only use her words and ask how it's showing up for her.
Is there a reason? Can you think why you may have been holding on to the blame?
Okay, that's a pretty advanced question.
One way to fill our cracks in the fold is sometimes to bring in an advocate, a higher self to give us perspective. Who would you like to bring in?
Because she doesn't know the price yet of this belief. She hasn't expressed how it shows up for her in her life. So right now, there may not be a motivation to let it go.
What does the Savior say to you?
Okay, did she say the Savior? Hang on.
One way to fill our cracks in the fold is sometimes to bring in an advocate, a higher self. Who would you like to bring in to help you fill this in the cold?
Okay, so the advocate always needs a frame-up. So one thing we avoid saying in belief breakthrough itself is the word advocate because it's got a sticky factor for legal sorts of things. So what we'd like to do is frame it up. So we frame it up in a way that says, who would be someone that you trust, someone who's got your back, someone who's inner corner, someone you can rely on? Who would that person be for you? That's how they frame up the advocate so that when they think of someone, they think of them in those terms. Okay. I'm not sure if she said that or not.
What is the same?
I couldn't hear. Did she? I hope she said that. Invite her to speak as if she were the advocate or the Savior in this case.
He loves you. It's not your fault. Are you ready to give gratitude to the old? Sometimes our limiting beliefs, when we try to force them out, they have to walk their way. Nobody wants to be forced out. Can you say thank you to being stuck so you can let go?
That's a little bit off script. So if you're going through a limitless belief breakthrough script, I would leave that portion specifically out.
Savior told you the truth. You're loved. So what's a new belief you want to create about yourself?
Good question.
I believe I'm just the way I am.
Good belief. Good girl.
Just the way you are.
Okay, time to bring the audience in. They've been left out. You see this little side conversation happening here. They've been left out of the conversation for a little long.
Searching.
for a week and been stuck for a few years. And I found Barb. I found Social Code and Body Code. And I've been able to help myself and other networks through that. And I've seen the amazing things that through that I can do. And I don't think if I had been as stuck as I have been for the last few years, I never have become who I am now.
What a blessing.
Yeah. Such a gift.
That's a beautiful realization
on
her part.
You are so amazing. I mean, what's happened?
We need an anchor.
Is that craft that you had led you to this even more beautiful perfection that is you now? Thank you so much.
Thank you.
All right, give it up for Shandy.
Okay, so in that spot, here's how I would anchor that from stage. I would have her turn out to the audience, and I would let her know, in this moment, we're going to invite you to anchor this in a very powerful way. So as you think of your new belief, and then you turn to the audience and say, we're going to show her how it feels to be 100% in this limiting belief. Can we celebrate this limiting belief with her? Then you invite everyone to get on their feet and celebrate as loud as possible. And then you turn back to her and say, okay, now it's your turn. I'm going to invite you to declare this limiting belief in the most powerful way that honors you. And audience, how are we going to show up for her? And then they practice again. And then you give her the chance to cement that in.
So now we have our powerful buckets. And I want us all to chime words of life. So I'm sure every single one of you wants to go to Crabs with Golden right now. I'm going to say a few words, and you're going to do that for me. I am beautiful.
Okay. So before you do this, it's a great idea to get new beliefs from the audience. So if you had beforehand, like we talked about, had them really get grounded and remember their specific limiting belief, this would be a great chance to have them formulate a turnaround. So you offer them, what would be a turnaround? Take a moment and think about what would be a new belief that would serve you better. Take a moment and think about that. Let's get some shares and then get some audience shares of what new beliefs are serving them better, and then have a partner share so they can turn to their partner and share that. And when you're doing the words of life, you can use the shares that you heard from the audience.
I am beautiful.
I am loved.
I am loved.
I am perfect.
I am perfect.
I am wanted.
I am
enough.
I am enough.
Thank you, beliefs, for serving me.
Thank you for
protecting me.
Thank you for
helping me find my higher perfection.
Thank you for helping me find my higher perfection.
You're all beautiful and filled with gold. Now that we're powerful buckets, capable of holding our abundance, let's go get it. Okay, let's go get our abundance. So the second tool I would bring with me on a deserted island would be a bow and arrow. Pretty simple. Why do you think I would bring a bow and arrow with me on a deserted island?
I'm holding on to see, but it feels like that breakthrough would be more powerful after we've gotten both tools.
Exactly.
But I'm waiting to see where you go with this.
For protection. Ooh, I like that. Yeah. I think so. This is our bow and arrow of manifestation. A mentor of mine once said, an arrow without a target always hits its mark.
Good quote.
Right?
Say it again.
I know I'm without a target.
Good girl. You can hear me.
So often in life, we don't get what we want.
Take out in life.
Because we don't know what we want. We're so focused on, oh, I don't want to be fat. I don't like this car. I don't like my marriage how it is. I don't like this house. We're so focused on what we don't want that we never get what we want. So if I'm on a deserted island, I'm not thinking, gee, I wish I wasn't hungry.
I mean, I'm hungry. I want a hamburger. I want steak. I want a salad.
Looking for a really strong state change here. We're back in this small wave energy. We need a state change from that really low moment to something really high.
But I have a bow and arrow, so I can go get this steak and you make some like deer hamburger, right? So I saw plenty of deer out yonder, and I know I'll hunt for the deer. I'm not a hunter, but my friends who are tell us that there's a very specific spot that you want to aim on the deer so you get a nice clean patch so they drop, right? And they don't get away. Hit too high, deer was wet, hit too low, the deer was sitting, what are you doing? So I'm aiming right beneath the deer's heart so it drops dead. And I'm very specific and I'm very precise. And where I'm shooting at the deer.
And being what?
An uncle of
specific and precise.
I'm not a religious man. I'm spiritual. But I know this. Specific prayers get specific answers.
Good. Repeat it. Specific.
When we're manifesting.
Okay, I want you to have them repeat that.
We need to be specific. How would you define what manifesting is? Have you guys heard of manifesting before? Okay, yes. What is manifesting?
Love Barbara. She's funny.
What you put out there, what you want.
Receiving what you want. Yeah. Anyone else? Brittany's looking at me. Oh, Jennifer.
Making your dreams a reality.
Yeah. Making your dreams a reality. Manifestation is an act of creation. It's bringing the spiritual into the physical.
Bringing the what?
We do it all the time.
Let's get some more state changes in there.
That manifest, like the noun manifest with a ship, it's actually a detailed log of what is on the ship. Okay, I know I've got 10 boxes of X, 37 boxes of Y, I have 52 passengers. The manifest is very detailed, specific, and precise. So if I'm wanting to manifest a vacation, I'm not thinking, gee, I wish I already got a burnout. I'm thinking, I want a trip. I want a trip with my husband. I want an exotic location. It's going to be a week long. And I'm going to spend under $2,000 to do it. Okay? Pretty specific. So right now.
Okay, you talk about specificity. You talk about specificity there. Let's give them really great specifics. Let's say, rather than just an exotic location, I want it to be in Hawaii. I want to be with my husband. I'm going to be there for a week. I'm going to be in a five-star all-inclusive hotel. It's going to be in Mexico. We're going to Puerto Vallarta. We're going to be on the beach. I can feel the sand between my toes. We're going to eat this, you know, specific kind of food while we're there. I'm looking forward to buying this as a souvenir. I can feel the salt on my skin from the air. I can smell the ocean. If you're talking about specifics, get super specific.
Together, turn to your neighbor and start telling your neighbor what it is that you would like to create. Be specific, be detailed, and get excited. Begin.
This is a cool process. I would invite them even to stand up and find a partner to do it.
I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to do that.
Get my warning. Make sure you give them a warning. Okay, so in this partner share, you're going to give, okay, pick a partner A, partner B, partner A. You have 90 seconds, go, and then you're going to say, and switch partner B. So they have some direction. I just love you, Kristen. Good morning. I just love how you're showing up. I just love what you're creating. I love that you are just in front of these amazing ladies and doing such a superb job. You're super fun, super engaging, and you make a really beautiful space. Yeah, say switch instead of change. Good feedback. You're getting lots of natural feedback from your audience. Okay, now are we about done? Give it 10 more seconds. And stop. Okay, this is where we go. 10 more seconds. And stop. Give your partner a high five and say, you are creative, or something along those lines, so that they have a clear stopping point. What that also does is keep you from speaking over the crowd, so that you're not competing with them. A really cool thing to do here, Kirsten, would be to have a partner raise their hand and share what their partner said. So partner A would raise their hand and say what partner B wants to create.
Super A wants to create a peaceful morning before her baby wakes up. Feed the baby, feed yourself, peaceful morning, meaningful connection with your other children.
Okay, attach an emotion to that. What will it mean when you have that? How will it feel when you have that? Attach that emotion.
Who else would like to share what they want to manifest? Wait, oh, it's like, all right, we're going to take
her. Losing my camera.
Okay, so, Donna will talk about for us.
Okay. I want to.
Where'd you go?
A small Toyota or Nissan. That's great mileage.
Is a Toyota or a Nissan? What makes great mileage?
Very reasonable price.
What's a reasonable price?
Awesome. Small Toyota Nissan, good condition, good mileage for the next 2 months.
Good price. To get even better clarity. You're so general.
I believe Donna.
I've done it, so you can do it.
Jennifer's done it.
I never proved any resistance to getting a new car, and I got a new car for $6,000 less than what we looked at. It's like 2016. I've had the same
car for 10 years, had a totally beat up new car, and my
husband's
like,
let's go car shopping. And my body went, uh-uh, no, you're scaring the crap out of me, don't talk about car shopping. And he's like, no, we're not going to buy one, we're just going to test drive it. So then I
okay,
you're
losing control
of
the
room
here.
Was like, over was like $1,000, right? So the very next day, my husband's being out of car. And we drive past another car dealership, and there's the same car, but it has a racing
trip and a $6,000 Jeep trip.
Love it. I have a new car.
I manifested it because I felt resistance.
Exactly.
It was amazing.
It is amazing.
I challenge anybody to not resist driving a new car to see how it goes.
Okay, one more. Who else is creating something super powerful?
You
can talk again. It's fine. We like Jennifer, right?
Yes.
And how our space is going to be created. And so when we were doing our exercise, we were just bouncing off of each other back and forth what our plan is, which I think we've been doing that this entire time, which is why we found where we are.
Awesome. So you're manifesting a space to have your business in.
No, we have.
You have it.
We have the space. We have the space in less than a week of planning on having the space. And it was for way less than we planned on being. And then a space that we could build our own walls in, create our own space, like our rooms, how we want them. And so we've been making plans and things have been coming along.
So Dana has seen a really floor plan. Cool. So when it comes to manifesting and creation, it's important to understand how creation happens. First, start spiritual. You guys just did the spiritual creation. You thought about it. It's in your mind. You send it out to the universe. And you got specific. So the universe is like, huh, I got that message. Okay. Let's see how serious they are.
Paper.
So you show you're serious. You get to the emotional part of manifesting. You gotta talk about how it feels.
Okay, that's what I was talking about. You do want to get emotionally connected. So when you're getting those shares, ask them how it would feel to be there. What does it feel like to wake up in the morning and have that amazing day all planned out with your kids? What does it feel like to drive that new car?
So,
write a future letter.
Okay, write a future letter. Back to Jennifer. Let's talk about how does it feel
when
you're going to your business partner.
Just do it individually.
Imagine your floor plans out, and what were you going to be feeling in this beautiful space you're creating?
It's like I'm on vacation, but not leaving. Okay, it's like going into like the coolest space I've ever been in.
Cool. So, and how do you feel? Like, what emotions are you feeling when you're in the coolest suite you've ever been in? That's really peaceful.
Joy. Success, relaxation.
Can you feel it now? Can you, like, channel that energy and just sit in it?
Okay, that's more powerfully than saying, can you feel it now?
Right.
Invite them. Do a group process. Invite the entire group to close their eyes. Imagine what it would feel like to wake up one morning and you have what you were manifesting. What does it feel like to wake up in that environment and then just have them shout out some words to you? It feels peaceful. What are some words that you're feeling with that? Excited, peaceful. You're going to get those natural responses from the audience from a very grounded state, so it's more concrete.
Let's channel the emotional energy of your amazing hour before you feed your baby. How are you feeling?
Okay, observe that when she's speaking, she's saying it in a question. Joyful, that's because she's not quite connected yet.
And are you channeling this emotion right now? Channel it right now.
Okay, they need to learn how to do this.
Can you feel a connection? Imagine it. Scripture.
Imagine someone saying, feel joy. Feel joy right now. Feel joy. Rather than saying, close your eyes. Put yourself in that moment. What does it feel like? And then paint the picture for them so they can actually step into it.
Studies, did you say meditation? Did you say writing? Oh, you're doing your power hour stuff. Feel the joy, the production. Feel the flow that you create. Feel how effortlessly everything comes together. Easy flow. You got your me time.
on the quality time you have with your other child. You're effortlessly manifesting your errands to easily fill in place. No inches. Just flowing. Productive. Feels good, doesn't it, for me?
Ask her how it feels rather than telling her it feels good.
Nice. How do you feel in your car? It's exciting. How else do you feel? Very grateful. Grateful? Why is that?
Well, just because it showed up.
I would be grateful too. And was it hard?
Yeah.
It was so easy. Beautiful Toyota. Well taken care of. Low miles. Very nice. Good price. Showed up in a month, even though she gave a deadline of 2 months. Because Donna is a powerful creator. Donna feels successful. Donna is amazing. So, earlier Jennifer brought up a really good point about resistance. Sometimes when it's time for us to create, we get resistance, right? Like, hurry! I'm going to manifest all this weight! It's coming off! Weight's coming off! Oh my God.
I'm going to manifest the weight?
That's why I'm still heavy.
Hmm.
I know.
Are we going to manifest the weight or the healthy body?
I'm going to go back again. And we're going to manifest. We're going to manifest. And oh my gosh, I'm so scared where I am. It's so sad. You know, and sometimes when we want to create stuff, we actually get it back into scarcity, okay? It's easy to create spiritually. It's easy to create emotionally. But the final step of creation is physical. You gotta get all the spiritual and the physical. You guys are divine beings and you have this power. Do not doubt your power. So, we want
you
to
get background chatter, get control of the
physical room. And it's like staring that deer in the down of the eye when you are ready to let go of the arrow. And you're thinking,
state change, Kirsten. Give them a state change. You're losing people. I'm hearing a lot of chatter in the back of the room.
We're in the deer. Well, we would actually get rid of all, right?
There is a fear there.
There is a fear.
What if you miss? What if you love me?
What if I break my fingers on the bowstring? This is why it hurts. We want to freeze it.
What if you don't? You start.
What if it doesn't happen?
What if it doesn't happen? And what happens if it doesn't happen?
Well,
you're manifesting your fear. Yeah. So, scared city. Remember? War, fight, flight. We're fighting our deliverers. We're flighting to them. Final step is freeze. We're so scared to get what we want them. Don't
fight. Okay, you just gave them a beautiful nugget that is not common. The fight or flight response also has a freeze response. A lot of people don't know that. So make sure that you're giving that extra bonus piece really careful clarity.
You're crying. So for me, $1 million. For today. You guys are throwing me $1 million. Oh my gosh, you guys are throwing me $1 million. Did I catch it?
No. Alex.
Okay, try again. Alright, Alex, $30 million. No. I can't catch it. I'm frozen. Hurry, put it in my pocket. Okay. Oh, I have my pockets. I'm too frozen to get my wants. So, there's a simple way that we get out of this mode. And it's my favorite thing to do every morning in the shower. And we're gonna do it together. I like to do a fun dance for abundance. See? Jennifer and I got this connection. We're like psychic. I do a fun dance every morning for abundance. I'm going to show you how we're going to do it, and we're going to do it together. So, every morning I wake up.
Give them the, if you're going to have them repeat the cute little song, then have them repeat it in their seats first and then have them stand up.
You guys thought you were escaping the dance. Love it or not. Okay.
Yeah, what are we dancing for? Who's
it?
Okay, you want this right? Count of three, we're gonna do it three times in a row. Ready? One, two, three.
Money, money, I got the money, money. Money, money, I got the money, money. Money, money, I got the money, money.
Who's next? What else are we dancing for?
Okay, like losing weight, you know, I mean, that's like, I mean, it kind of scares me almost.
It can be.
Yeah, and so how do you do that?
Healthy body.
Help!
I love how you're asking.
She just brought up a really, really good point. And if she brought it up, you know that others are thinking about it as well. Acknowledge that. You just brought up a really good point, because what we think about most is what we bring about. What we think about is what we what? Bring about. So if we're saying over and over, lose weight, what is our brain hearing? Wait, 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 wait. And not only that, when we lose something, we typically want to find it again. So when you are trying to manifest this new body of health, what do you want it to look like? Is it fit? Is it strong? Is it lean? Is it limber? What are the words that describe this body? Get some shares and then pick the one for your song.
Like Jennifer said, skinny, skinny, I got the skinny, 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 I got the skinny, skinny, skinny.
Look at her, look
skinny,
at her.
I got the skinny, skinny.
Bring her up with you.
Finally, let's do a butt dance for one more thing. Who's got it?
The car, let's do it for the car.
Let's do it for the car. All right. One, two, three.
Car, car, I got the car, car, car. Car, I got the car, 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 I got the car, car.
Oh, yay, good job, ladies.
Give yourself,
you guys are amazing.
Give them, have them give themselves a round of applause.
Wasn't that fun? Yeah. Wasn't that easy? So much fun, guys. Living in abundance, it's not in your pocketbook. It's never about your pocketbook. It's about your heart. It's by your mind. I just got back from a humanitarian trip in Kenya. I saw people who had nothing. Their food was raw. Who here wants to call upon this power? Raise your hand. I know who here wants to master this power. Raise your hand. My friends, and I do mean it when I say friends, I feel like I love to talk to you guys. I'm putting together an 8-week abundance mastery class. When I was sick and I was stuck in bed and I was miserable, I mean, we had other people providing Christmas for us. There were six principles that I utilized that got me out of bed. I don't have diabetes anymore. My adrenals are not broken anymore. I can move. I can run. And not faint. I'm not infertile anymore.
Did you really faint while you're running? Or is that a quote scripture? Make sure that's clear.
Not having control over who you are. And with these six principles, I called into creation $130,000 to start my business. These six principles changed my life. Who here wants to know these six principles? I'm putting together a class.
Okay, this is where it's getting a little bit. This is where it's getting a little bit salesy. Telling people that you've got something, and making them sign up for a 6-week class to get it is where the sales pitch feeling comes in. So, make a way, and you might be doing this in the next. 7 seconds. If you offer them a strategy session, offer those six principles over the phone for free.
We will do all the internet fundraising that we need to do.
Okay, awesome, Kirsten. I'd like to see this on, I understand that you presented this on the regional stage, so I'd like to see the recording of that. And I look forward to talking with you later. Great job.